we present Big Jim and the Figaro Club, with Norman Rossington as Big Jim, Roland Curram as Harold Perkins, and Bernard Cribbins as our storyteller. Episode 1, Transport of Delight.
Remember just after the war, all our lads picking up their old trades in Civvy Street? Now they'd done for old Jerry, they was going to build themselves a land fit for heroes, right? And there were still a few old soldiers from previous campaigns and all deciding to take up where they'd left off in 1939. Old Ned, for instance. After 6 long years of pain and anguish and hand-to-hand combat,
she was a strapping lass with Mildred, all right.
He'd give thanks for his God-sent liberation.
Husband Stanley on doorstep in demob suit.
And trudged it all the way to the south coast with nothing but the implement of his ancient craft.
I do hate this shovel.
And then he glimpsed the good old English Channel and a nice little harbour town. Kind of inviting and make yourself at home.
Boghampton-on-Sea. Oh.
Hang about, though. Who's this geezer with a wax tash striding up and down with a whopping great placard all on his tod in a buttercup meadow?
I've been polishing the sun.
She'll never fathom Southerners. Make yourself scarce behind edge, Ned lad. Young fellas do lally.
Oh, the world's just how I like it. Everything's going my way. Oh, Harold, you ain't half gonna be the kiddie up here. Get this Anne's wanted board planted. You soon have your own workforce. Have them all calling you sir. Yeah. Just think. Oi, you in the act?
Yes, Mr. Perkins, sir.
Wheel them 10,000 bricks over here, double quick. You in the bald head?
Yes, Mr. Perkins, sir.
When him in the hat's finished wheeling them over here, you can start wheeling the breeder's back over there.
He's a re-ed case.
Won't be long now, Harold. Your own site office, your own telephone, your own car, even. As soon as they get their fingers out down the tunnel. Get this one right, Harold Perkins. The sky's the limit. Today, clerk of the works. Tomorrow, building inspector. Then it'll be Councillor Perkins, the Rotary Club Justice of the Peace, the Masons. You scratch my back, old boy, I'll scratch yours.
He must have fleas.
Henry, where did you spring from?
Armitage Road, Pontefract, if it's out to thee.
Well, you're trespassing on Boghampton Council property. This land, compulsory purchase from the farm across the river, nobody allowed on this estate except on official business, Grandad, so sling your hook.
Estate? No, but field. You watch out, Sithy. Men in white coats will fetch thee to Funny Farm else. Thee and their banner.
This ain't no banner. This here's a sign. Can't you read?
All I knows is how to shovel.
Well, I shall be needing ground labourers.
No fear of a job, is there?
You're hired. You may set to here and now to excavate the temporary field sanitation.
The what?
The crapper, man, the crapper. Yard square, deep as you like. Now then. I've got other things to do apart from take executive decisions. Planning at the highest level, measuring out. So you take this sign.
Oh, ta.
And get it erected, prominent, there. I expects you to work unsupervised while I gets on.
Hey, I really do hate this shovel.
Yeah, but old Ned couldn't half graft with that shovel of his. No time at all. He's up to his neck, down his latrine hole, with the clods flying out like flocks of pigeons. Meanwhile, who should be coming in the far end of the field, running his little dog, but a fresh-faced lad who is getting a bit of a talking to from a sturdy ex-matelot.
So listen here, young Nimrod. No more playing with matches, understood?
Fair enough, Jim. Blinking good bonfire, though, wasn't it? 7 fire engines, blimey!
Yes, son, but schools is expensive. Once you think yourself lucky, you ain't got to pay for it. Bad enough getting slung out.
Yeah,
what would your dad have said, my old shipmate, eh? I promised to keep you out of trouble, didn't I? After the torpedo, like? All hands in the oggin. Keep a weather eye on young Nimrod, Jimmy says. Before he goes down the third time. So.
Oh, what's up, Jimbo? Oh, shall I have a butcher's, Jim?
Off you go.
me.
Evening, what have we got here, then?
Well, get out of it, Jimbo. Here, Jim. It says hands wanted on this board. Hands wanted? All right, what do you want hands for, Grandad?
To help me out of here.
Come on, then. A one, a two, a six. Come on.
Oh, tar lads. Happen you want, Governor? That's him on his hands and knees, bit riverbank, on the end of that there little dog.
Pick it up, you. Here, call off your house.
Jippo! Jippo!
Hail, Jippo! Savage, innit, for a little un.
Listen here. I do not intend to have my private parts mauled by no wolfhound while I'm bending down doing my measuring. And I ain't having my labour force interrupted neither.
Old art, Mr. Perkins.
Never mind about no old art. Oh, you knows my name. I dare say you saw me picture in the Bockhampton Bugle. Clerk of the Works appointed. It's quite a good likeness. It got me best side.
No, remembers you from before the war. Rates office. A bit of a pen pusher.
That was then. Worked me way up. And I intends to get on top and stay on top.
It's what Mildred Allride Aldous said.
You?
Who, me?
Yes, you. Back in your role.
Oh, Arthur
Moe, I knows who you are and all. You're that carpenter from Catchpole Street. Did a lot of subcontracting for the council before the war. Had your own little lorry.
That's right. Just come out the Andrew.
Hey?
The Navy. Oh. CPO stoker in destroyers. What was you?
I was more of your forces executive type. Oh. If you notice what I mean.
Clerk in Paycor, like.
Got your hair mushy.
When we wants the monkey, sonny, we shall rattle our bag of nuts. Speaking of wages, Mr...
Crampton, Jim Crampton.
Uh-huh. I could do with a craftsman like yourself, man of experience, somebody who could...
Show you how things is done, like?
Well,
Setting out an oversight for a start. Making a pig's bum out of that one, ain't you?
Goes without saying I'd be very much in overall charge.
Might consider it. As long as you takes on young Nimrod here and all.
Him? He's only a pimply kid.
First things first, Mr. Perkins. Got to have a tea, boy. Your cup of char.
Aye. Got to have a brew up.
Oh. All right, then.
Ray!
Henry, always this now.
Two blokes on one bike. Pushing the pedals was a real wild jock from Glasgow. Just got out of the RAF glasshouse. As for his passenger, clean-cut young fella, he'd been a storeman with the same mob. And what's more...
Tell you what, Mr. Perkins. Him on the crossbars, best bricky in Bockhampton. Give him a start, you got any sense? Good, sensible, quiet fella.
Watch it, Jim.
Watch it, chick. Who's your mate?
Some mad bugger I met down the labour. Painter, ain't you, China?
Aye. My friends call me Tops.
Right, Jim. Where we start, then?
Just one minute. You two don't start nowhere, Mush. It's me what decides who gets took on around here. Understood, Mr. Crompton?
All right.
Very well. I have uttered.
So's the town clerk. Eh? Had us both not 10 minutes ago.
What?
In person. Aye. So pick the bones out of that.
And the town clerk said to tell you, no materials due to the shortages.
And you'll no be getting your sight office yet.
Nor your phone. Have to get your messages from the farm over the river.
And a car, aye. Didn't forget a car.
Oh, yeah. Got to wait for that and all.
Henry bleeding all. How do they expect me to get cracking on building the post-war world?
Never mind. Have a bit of a sit down by the river. Calm yourself, as the saying goes.
Yeah, all right. Yes, I will. I've got to think what to do. Five workmen and no flaming work. It ain't fair, it ain't
fair. Oh, blimey. You've been having to do for ages.
Nothing but draw our pay.
Right cushy number.
Except for me down this hole.
Hey. Hello, alert all hands. Over the river, look. Farmer's daughter.
Oh, look at them. Not mind getting inside her milking parlour.
Not in front of the lad, Terps. Listen.
What is it? Town hall on the blow-up?
No. Low scaffolding. The driver's dumped it all in our yard. Said he couldn't be bothered to go all the way round by the bridge. My darling, half off in mad.
Right.
Oh, nice bleeding straw. Barring hands, without my say-so, no materials, no side office, no telephone, no car, and now a load of scaffolding that I can't use and what's in the wrong place. So, listen, you men. I now propose to betake myself down to that town hall and rip off a strip or two during...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.